friends, here we will talk about a concept that is called bucket overflow. Now, when a record is inserted, the bucket is which it is mapped has space to store the record. If the bucket does not have enough space, a bucket overflow is said to occur. Now, say already we have seen that. What is bucket? Already we have seen that. A hash file store data in a bucket format. Bucket is considered a unit of storage. So these are the buckets, the bucket 0, bucket 1, bucket 2. Unit of bucket. A bucket typically stores one complete disk block. This is what? One complete disk block. So first disk block, second disk block, third disk block. Okay. A bucket store computer which in turn can store one or more records. So here one record may be there or more than one record is there. So next we'll talk about the bucket overflow. Now these are the buckets, say bucket 2 is there, before that bucket 1, bucket 0 are there, bucket 3, bucket 4, bucket 5 are there. Now suppose it is what? Modulo 10, apply modulo 10, so 3. So it will store in bucket 3. So here we store roll number 3. Okay, say name is Subhash Chandra Bose, and Subhash Chandra Bose, and class say BE. Okay, modulo 3, it is a Bhagat Singh, and roll number say 53. Okay, so it is a Bhagat Singh, and something say it is MTech. Similarly, modulo 10, it is 3. Here we can store. Say K Gandhi. Okay, so 63 M K Gandhi, M Gandhi. Okay, and say class A PhD. Now suppose you want to say another roll number is there. Say 43 modulo 10. It is say Nehru. Now for Nehru there is no space here. So this concept is called. This is called bucket overflow. So because the bucket don't have the enough space. Now the question is reason for bucket overflow. Now insufficient buckets and skew. Okay, so first is what? Insufficient buckets. Now to allocate a buckets, to know the number of buckets required, we have to use this particular condition. NB should be greater than NR by FR. So what is NB? NB is nothing but number of buckets. It is the number of buckets. What is NR? NR is the total number of records that will stored, say roll number, and FR is what? Number of records that will fit in a bucket. So NR say total number of roll numbers, say 100 students are there, and each bucket store 10 records. So definitely we need 100 by 10. 10, we need 10 blocks to store the roll number. Generally the number of buckets is chosen to be NR by FR into 1 plus D, where D value is typically around 0.2. That is around 20% of the space in the bucket will be empty, that but overflow is reduced. That means what? If it is NR, if it is say NR and it is say FR and we use 1 plus D, so this is nothing but our D. So 100 by 10 into 1 plus 0.2, it is what? If you solve it, you can get the 12 buckets. So if you use this particular formula, the answer is about 10 buckets. If you use this particular formula, the answer is 12 buckets. That means to allocate 100 students, we need 12 buckets. So if you allocate some more, we can reduce the overflow problem. Next is skew. Now some buckets are assigned more records than are others. So a bucket may overflow even when other buckets still have space. This situation is called bucket skew. Okay, so are you getting this one? So bucket skew means what? Suppose we can say we allocate the buckets based on the alphabetical order. See, we can say roll, say name, say if it is start from S, we have to allocate this block. If start from say P, we have to allocate this one. If it is start from say Q, start from Q, allocate this one. Or if it is start from Z, allocate this one. Okay. Now definitely maximum names are from S and P. So very few are from few names are there where starting alphabet is what? Q or Z. So definitely this will enter, or here it will full early as well as compared to the Z and Q. Okay, so reason for skewness. So skewness means what? So if you see the alphabetical order, say if it is A, B, C, D, E and F. Okay, so number of keys are very high, B say low, okay, D say very high, C for C, for D it is say moderate, for E it is say very low, for F it is very so. That means what we can say, this is the situation is not, it is not random, okay, it is a skewed, okay, it is a skewed like this way, it is a skewed. So data itself, it is a skew, definitely skewness is the skew problem must be there. So reason for skewness, multiple records may have the same search key. Okay, so C, multiple records, maximum time it is C, or the chosen hash function may result in a non-uniform distribution of the search key, or it may be possible that it is a random but non, the function is what, non-uniformly distributed to the keys and insert into the bucket. Two are the reason for bucket overflow, insufficient buckets and skewness. So insufficient buckets, we have to use this particular formula to solve this particular problem, and for skewness we have to see the data properly to check how to solve it. Okay, so if the data distribution itself is skewed, so definitely the overflow problem will occur. But if it is a roll number, that means what, it is uniform. Okay, roll number is what, uniform. So in that case no skewness problem is there. So what is overflow buckets? Despite the allocation of a few more buckets than records, bucket overflow can still occur. Okay, so we have seen that using this particular formula we can allocate some more buckets. So despite the allocation of a few more buckets than records, bucket overflow can still occur. We handle bucket overflow by using overflow buckets. So overflow bucket is a term, we use the concept overflow bucket to solve this particular collision. Now there are two techniques, closed hashing and open hashing. So for closed hashing we use overflow chaining and we use linear probe, that is nothing but another solution, that is the nothing but open hashing. Now first of all, see what is overflow chaining. Now all the overflow buckets of a given buckets are chained together in a bucket list. Suppose here these are the roll numbers and these are the values, and here you have to apply the modulo 10. So it is what? It will be what? 1. So here you have to store say 12911. Similar another 10, it is say 1. Here you have to store the data 62571. So we have to store in bucket 1. So roll another value say 67221. So it is what? Module 1. Here you have to store 67221. Now another value is there, here it is also 1. So how to do it, where to store? So if you use overflow chaining, we use the linked list. Okay, so use linked list to solve it. So here we have to allocate another bucket using linked list. Okay, here we put the values. So the next we have to use here 4252591. Here next it is also modulo, it is 1. Okay, so here we have to store 20061. Okay, next value is also 1, 79251, 79251. Next also, it is also 1, modulo 10, it is 1. So definitely here we have to add another bucket. And we can store here 42211. And this particular concept is applicable to any one of the bucket. So here also you can add buckets if it is required. Here we can store the records. So this concept is called overflow chaining and it is called closed hashing. Next solution is what? Linear probing. Now it is what? It is open hashing. Okay, so a linear probing is nothing but open hashing. The set of bucket is fixed and there are no overflow chains. So here in closed hashing it is not fixed, number of buckets are not fixed, so here we can add more buckets here. But in linear probe, the size, the number of buckets, it is fixed. Okay, so this is for bucket 0, bucket 1, bucket 2, bucket 3. And if a bucket is full, the system insert record in some other buckets. That means what? Suppose here 12911 modulo 10 is 1. So we have to store in bucket 1. So here we have to store the data 12911. Second data we can store here, say 62571, because same modulo 1. Next is what? 67221. Now if it is there, if another data is there, and here the modulo 10 is 1. So what you can do, so you have to see the another bucket, so the next bucket. So if it is a full, okay, empty, yes, it is empty. So here you can store, say 4, 2, 5, 7, 5, 7. No. Now suppose it is not full, it is not empty. Say 7, 8, 6, 3, 2 is there already there. So what will check? So first of all, it will check its own bucket. Okay, so B1, so it is already data is there. And it will check the another bucket. Now here also the data is there, another data is there for this particular bucket. But the next value is empty, this particular portion is empty. So here you can store the data 4, 2, 5, 9, 1. Are you getting this one? So for storing this way, also for retrieving data, for searching a data, we apply the same concept. Suppose we have to check whether roll number 6, 7, 2, 2, 1 is there or not. So how to do this one? So we have to apply the modulo 10, it is 1. Okay, so we have to check whether 1 is there or not. Now we have to check first module, bucket 1. So 6, 7, 2, 2, 1, 6, 7, 2, no, 6, 7, 2, no. So yes, the data is there, and we can say, then we can read the record. Now we have to check 9, 3, 5, 2, 1 is there or not. So obviously the bucket will be what? It is 1. So 9, 3, 5, 2, 1, 9, 3, 5, 2, 1. So search the bucket 1. So 93521 is there? No. 9352 is there? No. 9352 is there? No. And definitely it will check further. So 93521 is there? No. 9352 is there? No. After that it is blank. So it will stop its searching. Similarly, check whether 42591 is there or not. So 42591? No. 42591? No. 42591? No. 42591? No. 42591? Yes. And read the record. So this is called linear probing. So remember one thing. So linear probing is what? It is nothing but our open hashing. Okay, you can see. Linear probing is what? It is open hashing, and overflow chaining is what? It is closed hashing. So if you add extra buckets, so that is called, it is called overflow chaining, and that is the closed hashing. Now, for we use open hashing. So that is, for example, linear probing. Okay, for compiler and assembler to form a symbol table. But for the database system, for DBMS, for database system, we have to use closed hashing, and this concept is important. So for the database purpose, we have to use this particular closed hashing, that is overflow chaining, to store the data. Now one small concept is there, that is called hash indices. Now hashing can be used for index structure. So already you have seen. So this is what our index structure, where this is the student table data file, and we have to create a separate index file where we store the search key and the addresses. Suppose we want to search whether roll number 9 is there or not, so apply binary search and read this particular information and read this particular memory address, and directly you can jump that particular record. Now here we may implement the index table using hashing. Okay, so hashing can be used for index structure also. A hash index, this is what our hash table, a hash index organizes the search keys with their associated pointers into a hash file structure. So this is what bucket 0, bucket 1, bucket 2, bucket 3. Okay, now here suppose first row is 193. Now apply modulo 10, it is 3. So here we have to store this 193 in this particular bucket 3. So here you store 193, and here address, here now in this particular part there are two parts are there. Say this is what our the search key, okay, and this is what our memory address. Okay, so here 193, here the memory address, say it is A5. Okay, so it is say A1 A2 A10 A11. So in A5 we store 193. Now name is Bose, okay, and phone number is there. Next is what modulo 10, it is 2. So here bucket 2, in bucket 2 you have to store 272, and address may be say it is say A2. So in A2 we have to store 272. Okay, name say Patel, and phone number is there. Are you getting this one? So similarly, another is what? It is say 650. So it is 0. So in 0th block we have to store, so it is say 650 and address say A1. So in A1 we store address about this, say roll number 650, okay, say name is Bhagat Singh and phone number is there. So this concept is called hash index. So use both the concept of hashing. Here we use what? Hash function to identify the buckets, and in buckets we store two parts are there, the search key value as well as the address part, and from the address we can have. Now here we can say in hash table we can add some more buckets here. Okay, suppose it is full, say 272, 122, 392, all are full. Now here you can add one more buckets to store the next information, say 522, okay, 932 and so on. And that is the end of this particular video. In the next